A servant of God, I am Robert Simon. Beloved in Christ, loving greetings. Faith. We are continuing on the same topic in our word study. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 reads, "But without faith, it is impossible to gratify God or to make God happy and satisfied. For he that cometh to God or draweth nearer to God must believe that he is, that God is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." It doesn't mean that we have to believe that God is in existence. It is to believe who God is as he says. In my last talk, I read to you a passage from the book The Dangers of a Shallow Faith by A.W. Tozer. We must believe God is what he says he is. If someone thinks God is all-loving and all-powerful, he may not find answers for the questions such as, "Why are there sufferings on the earth? Where is God when helpless and hapless young innocent children are raped? Why can't he stop the plague? Why tsunami? Why, if he is all-loving, the hell there is hell?" If someone apologizes for God and says, "God is all righteous, God is all holy, without holiness no one can come nearer to God, God is a jealous God, God is a consuming fire," then is he merciful, gracious? Does he love a sinner or only truth? In our own thinking, in our concepts, in our own philosophy, in our own fancy ideas, we create our own God and believe, tell others, preach that he is God and end up in total obnubilation with no clear idea who God is. It is better to conform ourselves what God is than correcting or corrupting or creating our own false gods. At some point, our faith will collapse. We will have more questions than answers. The more we want to know, the more our faith will be shaken. It's all because we are believing God our own make than believing what he says he is. This is paramount principle of faith when we draw nigh unto him. Now, here I may be permitted to remind you what Tozer says. It would be a great and bitter error for a man or woman to go on for a lifetime believing certain things about God only to learn they were not true. To think they were talking to the God of heaven and earth and find that they were talking to a God fashioned out of their own imagination. It would be a tragic calamity to the human spirit to pray and preach a lifetime about a God who was not the true God, but a composite of ideas drawn from philosophy and psychology and other religions and superstitions. God is what he is. The word of God reveals God to us. That word is God. So we have to study the word of God thoroughly with the light of the Holy Spirit, having our ideas about God modified. Let that word of God give us a light, a revelation, a hearing, and that hearing by the word of God will give us faith to believe God is as he says what he is. We shall, God willing, be continuing on Hebrews 11:6. Till then, God bless you, God be with you. I am yours, Robert Simon.